Oh yeah, welcome to John's Comfy Stream Game, The Rest of the Wicked, Part 1.
No, damn it, I told you it was the fucking Zerp stream. Because I'm sick.
I already made the thumbnail. I already named the video. So welcome to John's Comfy Stream Game, The Rest of the Wicked, Part 1.
What does that even mean? How is the train wicked?
No, it's The Rest of the Wicked. Alright, I'm sending those links out there. We're hammering the fucking internet. Smash that like button 100.
You didn't even send it to people and it's already going?
I can't send the link before it's already started, you faggot.
So what you're saying is, I still have a chance to steal this back and tell someone, hey, welcome to the Zerp stream.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh look, there's another viewer. Hey, welcome to Rest of
the Zerp stream. No, you're a fucking lie.
No, that's what I said.
It's the John's. No, it's not what you said. It's the John's sick as fuck. Let's have some comfy trains and talk about how Brexit isn't a breakfast cereal.
No, it's a very complex political democratic choice that was made in the UK.
Oh, hey. You know what we didn't do?
What?
You'll figure it out in about 10 seconds.
Wambo!
Wambo!
Am I still as loud in here?
Yeah, I can hear you just fine. I don't know anything about settings, because I'm not that guy.
Wow.
Your job is settings, and look at this beautiful, desolate wasteland.
California.
That's 100% realistic depiction of California, to be honest. Ugh. There's the grapevine over there. You can see it.
I'm gonna kill.
Kill what? Kill California? Because I wouldn't blame you. It's
I'm gonna kill.
Agami will kill?
Anime could kill? I don't know what that is. What the fuck are you talking about? Don't bother me with this thing. Don't bother me with this.
It's better than Flubber.
I'm sorry, but Flubber was a seminal classic.
Flubber was garbage.
Flubber was pretty good, though.
No, it wasn't.
We have two viewers, and I'm kind of convinced that that's probably me and you.
That's absolutely me and you. See,
are you watching?
Yeah, I am.
And I am, but I think I'm the one who would count. Like, it's my account, so I don't think it counts me.
Is Druin around? Maybe it's Druin.
View active users. There are no active users. That's only Ed chat users. Damn it.
Oh, well, that's okay. Maybe the sick stream is just for us.
Yeah.
There you go. Does that make you feel better?
No.
Look, let's be honest. We do our best work when no one's around.
Put out 2 new videos.
What?
I put out 2 new videos.
Nice. How...
Contemplations on Existence, Volume 1 and 2.
Volume 1 and 2.
1 and 2.
1 and 2.
I also had like 4 beers today.
Really? Why? Why are you an alcoholic now?
I went to my dad's house and had 4 beers because he had a bunch of beer.
Oh.
It was over the course of like 3 hours.
What kind of beer was it?
One of them was an alcoholic root beer that was really nasty.
Gross.
It had an aftertaste like cough syrup.
That's disgusting.
I drank most of it, but then I had a moose head.
A moose head, huh?
I think I had 2 moose heads overall. No, I had the Rootbeer, I had a Moosehead, I had a Big Kahuna, and I had a Shiner Bock.
You're just a regular old alcoholism.
I will never pay for alcohol with my own money.
Why don't you just tell me how you get ripped, slipped, and stripped on Alizé all the time, for fuck's sake.
I mean, if I was going to be an alcoholic, I'd probably do it, because you can get some pretty nasty alcohol that's pretty cheap, but it's not my thing.
Nah, it's really not worth it. You'll just fuck up your brain and your life and everything.
Yeah. So there's nothing wrong with a couple of social beers at my dad's house.
Why did your dad have this collection of alcohol?
Well, we went to the local liquor store, and they had a thing where you can choose, like, six. You can make your own six-pack.
Oh.
And they have, like, this big thing full of all kinds of different bottles of alcohol, and you just choose six of them for, like, $10.
Oh.
But I came over, so then we did that, and then another... And then my stepbrother came over with his girlfriend, and then they went and did that again, so...
Neat.
Yeah. And we watched, like, the first episode of Stranger Things.
Oh! I just watched the first three of those today.
What did you think of it? I watched the first one episode, and then I saw, like, bits and pieces of two while people were talking.
I would say it's... there's eight of them, as far as I know, I think.
Right? Yeah.
I really like it.
I like the style of the music. Like,
yeah, they really nailed the... there's a lot of times I almost get upset at it because they nailed the 80s cinematography really well, except that... I think this is kind of a strange thing to complain about, but the equipment they use puts out video that's too high quality for the 80s, so I know it's not from them, and that makes it harder for me to enjoy.
Hmm.
Does that make sense? Like, so what I'm saying is, like, they nail the aesthetic so well that I expect the footage to be lower quality than it is, because I expect it to actually be from the 80s and filmed on, like, not modern equipment.
Yeah.
But then it's super high def because it's a modern show.
Yeah. Yeah, the intro screen is pretty good. I really like all the music when they play, like, the synth stuff.
Yeah, they did a really good job of nailing that stuff, I feel like. It reminds me a lot of...
I don't get the plot so far. I was way more into it in the first episode, where it seems like you saw a monster and, like, the silhouette of it that scared the kid, and it looked like, oh, shit, is this a fucking skinwalker or fucking Wendigo? It seems like it's more some sort of, like...
They keep the, like, they... You get to see a little more of the monster. But not, like, a whole lot. It's definitely a weird thing. Yeah. They kind of salt in some... Like, kids... I don't know. I like it so far. I'll admit that... I almost feel like I've already seen too much of the monster. I think they could have gone maybe a little less on it, but...
Whereas I've seen two episodes, like, one and a half episodes, and I haven't seen anything of it. So, they must lay it on thick in episode three.
Not exactly thick, they just... I guess they just don't shy away from showing it.
Yeah.
Maybe I've seen four episodes, I don't know. I could really be just... It could be a case of, like, I watched a bunch of them in a row, and, like, if it had been a TV show that aired on a regular schedule, you maybe wouldn't have that feeling, because you'd be getting, like, a little bit of it every week.
So what you're saying is that you're a big D with a little P.
Listen, you fucking flubberist. I didn't crawl out of my deathbed to fucking sit here and listen to you talk some bullshit. Like, I just wanted to sit in my train and look at some nice California wasteland and maybe talk about this cool new show I watched. And you're over here kicking off with fucking Death Stranding tier memes, just fucking. Meanwhile, I'm clawing my way up Everest just to stay in this goddamn chair and feed you. What the fuck? You, what the shit, man? Do you even, you don't even appreciate what I'm doing for you. I could just stop and then we'd be done, and then what would you do then?
You have fucking, a 10-minute video?
You shit. Yeah, you fucking shitter.
It'd be like one of our classic great game friends videos.
Two great game lords do dumb shit, part two. The continuation edition.
Like the Gran Turismo video where you just act like a dick the entire time and I accuse you of being drunk.
The Gran Turismo video was a piece of cinematography, classic work nature that is, it's gonna be, it's, nobody's watching this, why are we even doing this? I love it! No, that's a piece of legend, like that's gonna live forever. You're gonna die, and people are gonna find this shit in the future, and they're gonna try and decipher our culture based only on your videos. Man, the museums in the future are gonna be fucked up.
I wish.
Well, you know what happens when you wish upon a star? It fucking comes true, so.
Wow, I wished upon a star that I'd be dead by now.
Wow. Wow. Well, maybe stars don't grant stupid wishes. And you wish for something cool once in a while. What if stars only grant wishes for, like... What if they only grant wishes once the wish actually gets there? So nobody's wish gets granted because it has to go all the way across to wherever the star is? Which takes forever?
So, like, 6 million years?
Yeah, so, like, 6 million years later, your wish gets granted.
Cool. So then you're saying that I wish I was dead is a perfect wish for me.
Yeah, because then we'll just be like, well, this one's in the bag. I already nailed it. Sending it to the shipper. Good job, guys.
Wow, I was convinced that we'd have more viewers than usual, but we're having less viewers than the last two.
That's because we know a bunch of Europeans and late-nighters.
Someone is telling me that Yellowstone is going to blow tomorrow. And that I'm in the blast zone.
That's a meme. You're getting memed on.
Well, it is a super volcano.
Don't get memed on by some Keck Lord that thinks fucking Yellowstone's going to explode.
Oh, well.
I mean, eventually. Not tomorrow.
I mean, it's not like it could happen at any time.
Alright, so, like, look, here's the deal, though. Like, if it does happen tomorrow, then I'll look like an asshole. So it's fine. It's fine. It's fine, right? I'm pretty sure it's fine. Don't worry about a thing. Every little thing's gonna be alright. Oh, shit. That's how that song goes, right? Ah, fuck. Knocked over figurine. Don't die, Santa. Alright, so... Yeah, Stranger Things is pretty good, I think.
Yeah, it's okay.
I also watched some of Limitless.
I don't know what that is. What's that? Is that some dumb movie where it's like, well, I only have 10% of my brain, but now it's all...
Actually, yeah, it's it was a movie, I think even two movies, but then it got made into a Netflix-only TV series? I don't pretend to understand its legacy, but, it's okay.
Is it when they take, like, a drug?
Yeah, he has this drug that, like...
I think I've seen one of the movies.
Yeah, he has this drug that, like, lets him use all of his brain so he becomes instantly smarter. Except, I kind of liked it because all it really does is make him go from, like, kind of a shitty jackass to, like, a Ryan Reynolds, really good at everything jackass.
Yeah.
And then the FBI is like, you can't have this drug. It's bad for you. Stop it.
Well, it is bad for you.
Oh, yeah. He's totally dying from it. There's, like, a subplot where some congressman is like, I need you to do this thing. So he gives him, like, a magical MacGuffin that makes him so he doesn't get symptoms. And then he just does the drug a bunch. And helps the FBI solve a bunch of, like, mysteries and catch terrorisms and stuff.
Don't you think the FBI could just hire internally and make the person use the drugs?
Well, he's...
like, get the best guy in the FBI on
the
drugs?
Well, see, the twist is that because he has the magical MacGuffin cure for the symptoms, but nobody else has figured it out yet, so they hire him because they're like, well, you can either work for us and use this drug all the time, or we'll send you to prison. And then they do a bunch of medical experiments to try and see if they can reverse engineer, like, why he doesn't get symptoms. But mostly it's just a sort of, like, semi-comedy about how he just bumbles around and jokesters on the FBI all the time and helps him solve mysteries and stuff.
Yeah.
I wouldn't say it's...
I read an article that says that if it does explode, it would be like St. Helens.
Nice.
And there would be massive signs if it wasn't going to be that big, I guess.
Yeah, see, it's fine. Anyways, I'm trying to say it's limitless. I wouldn't say it's a great show, but it's kind of fun to watch if you want to watch something. It's just kind of stupid.
Alright, that makes sense. Well, we have 3 viewers, what?
Oh, we do.
Who else is watching? Say something, goddammit.
It's probably just Druin. Hi, Druin. Or maybe not Druin? I don't know. I'm not saying anything in the chat, so... not pressuring you, just saying we appreciate you. But yeah, so that's, Limitless was okay. Kind of was like a little bit of a Law and Order vibe, but without, overdoing it and making me, like, want to go away. You know, had enough Ryan Reynolds type humor. And, no, I said Limitless, not Unbreakable. Hi, guy. By the way. Thanks for hanging out. Yeah, but so, I haven't really watched any other of the Netflix, like, original shows.
Oh, it's our friend Guy.
Yeah. The other thing I find interesting is Netflix is totally banking on, anime and picking up a bunch of, quote, Netflix original animes, which is really just their code word for Netflix licensed animes. I realize I'm doing air quotes, and you guys can't see that, so just realize I'm doing that. Thanks.
I hate anime.
No, you don't. You fucking flubber fiend.
No, I hate watching other people discuss anime.
Oh.
I have terrible opinions.
Yeah?
I had to read SupGG talking about Kill la Kill earlier today, and it was the worst fucking thing.
Let me guess. They thought it was the best thing to ever exist. And,
no. They thought it was bad for dumb... well, it's like, some of them thought it was bad, but some of them thought it was good, and, like, all of them had terrible reasons for their consideration.
Okay, well, come on. Throw some at me here. We're in the train. We're talking about anime. I don't think we could make this more autistic unless we, like, turned it into a Kegel stream, so let's just go full force.
Kill la Kill is pretty okay. It's pretty good.
Wow. Wow, that's all I wanted to hear what they had to say that was bad or whatever.
Oh, I don't remember any of it. I was like, oh fuck, they're talking about Kill la Kill.
Oh.
Alright.
RailWorks is fun. Look at all the fun I'm having right now.
Yeah.
Driving through
to
the
my
wasteland.
Voice. Guy, listen to my voice and how excited it is for what we're seeing on screen.
It's amazing. It's like we're actually in California.
This is just stupendous.
Alright. Well, what would you suggest I put on that?
Stupendous is a good thing. Are you a fucking idiot?
Listen, nice. You flubber fiend.
I think Kill la Kill is pretty good. It nails the Gainax hot blood anime thing. You know, it's like a spiritual successor to Tangentapa. Good Lagann in a lot of ways. And I don't think the animation is quite as good, but there's a lot of good designs in it. And it has a lot of interesting ideas. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
Feel free to just ask me about any anime I've seen. I'll tell you what I think about it.
Denucoil.
Denucoil was pretty good. I liked it. Yeah, visually it was pretty nice. The characters were all kind of cool, nice. The plot was pretty nice.
Can you extrapolate on nice?
Music was pretty nice. Overall, it was just pretty nice. It's been a while, but it was pretty nice.
You're the worst.
The designs were nice.
Do you ever watch Haibane Reme, or however you say that?
I don't know what that is.
Guess not.
You're probably just saying it wrong, and I have seen it.
Haibane Reme. Haibane Reme. Haibane Reme.
Honestly, outside of the animes that you knew that I watched when I was like 16, the animes we watched together at your house when I was living there, I've watched like two series since then. So,
you can
ask about any of those ones.
Did I ever make you watch Toradora?
I've seen Toradora, yeah.
Yeah. I like that anime a lot.
That was pretty good, yeah.
I mean, I wouldn't really say it does anything different or special, but I really like it.
Yeah. The ending isn't terrible. So that was,
yeah, the ending
was getting a bit too heavy.
Yeah,
in the last parts, but then I was like, "All right, it ended fine." So yeah. I'm happy.
Yeah.
Started watching Initial D.
Initial D.
Yeah, Initial D.
Initial D.
That's pretty okay.
Do you get down when you watch Initial D?
What?
Get down. That one.
Excuse me, guy. That's Himoto Umaru-chan, and it's not a bear pajamas. It's a hamster pajamas.
It's not even pajamas. It's just like a weird fucking blanket hood thing.
It's not even pajamas. It's just like a weird blanket thing.
Fucking blanket kid. Oh, we're going under a bridge. Hi, bridge. Hi, bridge.
Yeah, I think Kamen Rider has consumed my anime watching.
Yeah, to be fair, the only anime I've really watched that I haven't watched with you recently is I don't know why, but I watched all of a show called Punchline.
Okay.
It was about a guy who's a ghost that has to go through like this weird looping time thing to save Earth from being hit by a meteor, but every time he saw somebody's panties, the Earth exploded.
Sounds pretty good.
It was, by the end of the show, it actually kind of was, when they finally like put all the pieces together, but the initial premise, I admit, is what got me there, and I was like, well, how the hell are you going to turn this into a series? And then somehow I ended up watching the whole thing all in one go.
I watched two Kamen Rider W movies again.
Nice. I watched almost all of the first Armored Trooper Votom series. That was really good.
Hmm.
If you can get down to the 80s anime.
I watched W/O's Movie War Core.
How was that?
Well, we watched it together. That's the one with
yes, I know.
The O's part is really horrible. It's like, you know, almost like watching a truck fire, you can't walk away sort of way. And the crossover part was pretty much that too. But the W part is just about Skull. Like the origin story of Kamen Rider Skull. And that's pretty good.
Yeah, I like that origin story.
It's really good. They explain things that, like, they didn't even know you wanted, like the origin of Count Up Your Sins, or the origin of the, pin-up boards that they use.
They explain
at the beginning of every episode in W.
W is basically just a shameless crib of Skull in every way. That he's a fumbling child that only knows how to emulate his betters.
Well, W is two people, and Shotaro is really cool. Don't insult. Because we also watched The Gaia Memories of Fate A to Z, or whatever. Which is the one with Eternal in it.
Oh, yeah.
And Philip's all sad, and he gets captured, and then Shotaro gets the... He turns into Kamen Rider Joker for the first time, and, you know,
yeah,
fights against all the odds. It was really cool.
I was joking. That's a good show, and those are cool guys in the show.
Yeah.
All right, well, how about some... Well...
Some blank, featureless desert?
Yeah. You like it? Is it good? No, you don't.
I'm starting to realize why no one watches these videos.
It's fine. It's
Maybe
fine.
We should stop leading with this game.
Hey, it's fine. We're gonna be done with that now, don't worry.
So, according to Fit, if you have to make protein like shakes, always make them with milk, because they taste really bad with water. But you have to make them with water anyway. You should pretend that it's Fudanari cum, and they're shooting it in your mouth, and then you're going to choke it down, according to this poster.
So what you're telling me is that in order to slurp down my hot workout deal, I should just pretend it's a bunch of jizz being dumped on my face?
Yeah, from a lady with a dick.
Okay. Sure. Why not? I don't see anything wrong with that.
Well, that's just according to Fit. I'm not a fitness man.
I mean, you could be. You could be. I've been working out recently, and, you know, I feel like it's paying off. You know.
According to this poster, you can just live off of milk with multivitamins.
I don't believe that. Oh, hey, Druin, what's up?
Hey, you made it.
You made it just in time for us to not be in the desolate wasteland of California.
And not for us not to be talking about Fit.
And for us not to be talking about drinking Futanari cum. Oh, the exciting times. The stream is already a million times more interesting.
Ugh.
What?
I'm hungry. Look at all these pictures I posted of. Post your cheat day meals.
Just
I'm gonna go to a different thread.
But. Just guzzle down your fucking Flutinari cum. Just go to town. On that shit. According to Fit, it's delicious. You know?
Yeah.
Yeah, oh look, there's a train again. I think you're sensing a theme in our streams. There's trains in them. Look at all these fuckers just walking around the main drag like it matters.
So, welcome to John's comfy stream game, The Rest of the Wicked Part 1.
Stop calling it that.
That's the name that is on the thumbnail and the video.
It's the fucking I'm sick. Let's zip the zerp, zappity zope thread.
For legal reasons, I can't have you admitting to the fact that you zerp before every stream.
I don't zerp before every stream.
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. You don't zerp before every stream.
Except, you know, when I'm sick, I do have to drink a lot of cough syrup. Like a lot.
Yeah. You're a very healthy person, so you have to drink at least 3 or 4 times the recommended dose.
It's the only way to get it to work. Look, this
mix that up with some Jägermeister and some 7-Up.
Mm. Now you're talking about my kind of business. My kind of business.
Add some lime juice and spiced rum. I call it poisoned cough syrup.
I call it the killing joke.
Good. It has nothing to do with Batman the killing joke.
I mean, it could. If you drink enough of it.
Yeah, you died and that one person got shot through the spine.
Take that, fucker. Anyways, I'm going to build this little roller coaster here. We're going to build it up, and then build it down, and then build it up again. Because that's how we do.
I had KFC today. Not enough. I hate eating fast food with other people because I never get enough. I hate to say it, but I'm so used to whenever I go to a fast food place, I don't do it as much anymore. If I'm going to, like, Burger King, you get, like, 18 of the... No, not 18, I'm sorry. Like, 6 or 7 of the absolute cheapest thing on their menu.
Okay.
Which provides way more than, in terms of how much you're getting versus how much you're paying, than ordering, like, value menus, meals.
Yeah. Value menu feels meals, I gotcha.
But chicken, fried chicken is pretty good.
But why would you be upset that you didn't get that?
I wanted to eat like 16 pieces of chicken, not just like 8.
I see.
It's a joke. There was a perfectly adequate amount of KFC.
Well, you know, if you weren't constantly joking all the time, I might be.
But I wouldn't be alive.
That's not what I was gonna say.
Have you ever seen that show, I Shouldn't Be Alive?
No, it seems like it'd be a pretty bad show, to be honest.
Well, that's the lead-in for my joke.
The punchline is, we're not funny. Oh!
Then, do you know anything about I Shouldn't Be Alive?
Isn't it a show where they're like, hey, this crazy thing happened, I totally should have died, but I didn't. Wow, who would have thought it?
Yeah, that's it.
Okay.
Pretty okay.
Is it really?
Yeah, it's alright.
Are we sure?
Yeah, it's alright.
But are we really sure?
Yes.
Are you under duress?
No, I'm not being under duress by the National Geographic Channel.
Are you being tortured?
No.
Okay. Okay. I just wanted to check. I was worried that maybe you didn't actually like the thing you were talking about. And that you were being tortured.
I mean, it's watchable. It's watchable in the same way as, like, Storage Wars.
Storage Wars is not watchable. Storage Wars is a form of torture.
It's
banned under
hole.
The Geneva Conventions.
It's like a TV black hole.
Okay. Well, is it watchable in the same way that, like, you could kind of just watch... What is that show? Not Garbage Pickers.
American Pickers?
Yeah, that one. It's basically Garbage Pickers. Is it watchable in the same way you could kind of, or like Drivers, Dine-ins, and Dives, that bullshit?
Yeah. Diners, Drive-ins, and Drives.
Diners, Drive-ins, and watch Guy Fieri slowly kill himself.
What have I become? My sweetest friend.
Pretty much that.
Yes, it's like that. Or you can just have it on in the background forever.
Dope, I made a roller coaster. Who would have thought I would do that in a game about making roller coasters?
What was I going to say? I forgot what I was going to say.
I don't know. I probably threw you off with all my crazy talk.
Oh, you were talking about the Geneva Convention. I was going to say we should do an anime convention in Geneva and call it the Geneva Convention.
I thought we made that joke already.
Did we make it on stream? I've said that before, but I wasn't sure if it was on stream or some other time we were talking.
Pretty sure we did.
They don't care. No one's going to see this.
Hey, Druin and Guy are seeing it right now.
Druin, have you heard that joke from me before? If yes, type. Yes,
ham
I have
sandwiches.
Heard this joke. My name is Druin, and I love Cornelius Vanderbilt.
He's not going to write that.
All right. Well, I'm going to use what they call, what the Indians call mace. Be right back.
Mace? You're going to mace yourself? All right, ladies and gentlemen, it's just me and you now. Some real quality John time. Real John out. Can hear my horrible voice.
Flubber.
This. Flubber. Don't you fucking flubber me! You shit! You were leaving! This roller coaster does not work. Oh, fuck. And fuckboys never stay dry made yet another emergency stop. This roller coaster looked really cool! And I wanted it to work. And I wonder if I can maybe fix it. Let's fix it. Constructalize me, Captain. Yeah, do that.
Oh no, Guy's going to bed. That's a shame.
Oh no!
A half of our viewer base. One fell stroop.
One fell stroop. Druin, you're fantastic. Please never forsake us for someone with real quality. Druin is hilariously drunk, which means we're fine. Everything's gonna be okay.
Druin, have you ever heard us say the joke about making an anime convention in Geneva and calling it the Geneva Convention? Yes or no? You can also, rather than the two choices, you can also write in a third party candidate, but we all know that's a wasted vote.
We all know that America will not accept that as an answer. Okay, I've pretty much got to undo like all of this roller coaster.
Well, what you have to do is first you have to rub in the Vaseline and leave it to soak for a few days.
Yeah, I should probably turn on low friction and see what it does.
And then you dump the entire thing in Simple Green.
No?
Man tries to trade kidnapped baby for 15 Big Macs.
Excuse me? Is this Florida Man? See, he has heard that. We have made that joke.
Okay.
And you're right. Quality content demands your attention. We only demand you turn the stream on and leave it on until we're done. That's all we ask.
Wow, Bad Dragon has a product called Tyrannosaurus Sex. Like the size of a man flexing his his arm, this extra large. Like four soda cans tall.
Can I just say that I really...
It's just like a man flexing his bicep.
I love that that company exists.
Whew. Yeah.
Just me think too. Of all the quality things that wouldn't exist if they didn't exist.
Yeah, there'd be a lot of weird dildos that wouldn't exist if it weren't for them. Right.
And I feel like life wouldn't be worth living if there wasn't some company out there shilling weird dildos. And damn it, you can quote me on that.
I mean, we all know you're a paid shill for them, so...
Yeah, by the way, the stream's sponsored by Bad Dragon. If you like giant horse wieners, if you like giant... Don't fuck up the spot! I'm trying to... Try and do the spot. Don't fuck it up.
Bad Dragon, if you want to sponsor us, let us know and we will accept no matter what.
Bad Dragon, we are desperate and do not care.
As long as you send people. You don't even have to pay us.
Druin, do you work for Bad Dragon? Because that's the only hope this video will ever get noticed by Bad Dragon.
Just send people that buy your things to us to watch our videos and we'll
talk about how great they are.
Yeah. We'll talk about how we bought a Flutter Hooves or some shit.
We'll talk about how I bought some kind of baseball bat-esque horse wang and used it to commit war crimes.
No, Guy. If we did make the Geneva Convention, everyone would go to the convention, but they'd all shit-talk it on like forums and stuff afterwards.
Yeah, pretty much. But that's like every actual convention anyway, so who cares?
Yeah. SakuraCon!
SakuraCon!
I love anime!
No, don't do it.
Cayman!
Stop it. We're not talking about the Cayman Islands here. I will kill you and your family.
DDR!
Fuck off. Jesus fucking Christ! I'm really trying here. I'm really pulling through the tears. I'm fucking sweating buckets. Just, I got the plague riding my ass and you're screeching this bullshit at me. I just can't even.
I found out where to buy those poster sleeves. But you have to do it online.
What?
Yeah, I went to the fashion board on 4chan. And they have a thread there, a general thread that's for like people who sell stuff at who apparently make it like their source of income to go to conventions and sell stuff in like artists markets and stuff.
Oh.
Then they have resources like where do you buy all the stuff you need? And one of the things is those. So
I would like that because I would like to put a lot of it makes me easier to put on the wall if they're like this fence is broken.
I have a bunch that I have never hung up because I don't want to ruin them. Like there's one of Hong Mei Ling.
Yeah, exactly. I have a bunch that I want to
one
do
of
too.
Like the Skull Kid. So they're just hidden away.
It just
being kept
it's,
perfectly
it's way,
preserved.
It's way easier to do that than it is to
I just don't want to ruin them because they're expensive and rare.
Well, yeah, and it's easier to do that than try and frame them because framing stuff. Don't what? What guy? Please.
I think he said that when you said don't when you knew that I was gonna say more stuff about SakuraCon.
SakuraCon! Nippon Ichi presents your worst nightmares. Trixie the Tiger, stop being pregnant! You
so
slut.
Would you ever go to Comic Con?
Hell yes! Look, I would go to Comic Con because then I would also get to go to Japan, and I'm not saying that in like a wow, Japan's really cool. I suck the weeb cock. That would just be cool because I've never left the U.S. So I get to go to...
Okay, we're confirming it here. Kevin and John confirmed we're going to be at C-108.
When the fuck is 108?
I don't know.
Well, look it up. We got to start buying tickets now. You might be joking, but I'm dead on. And if C-108 already happened, I'm going to be very upset. That's how long we got to learn Japanese, so we better get cracking.
Wow, the first Comic-Con was held on December 21st, 1975.
Wow, really? That's cool.
Comic-Con 91 will be December this year.
Oh.
So, what? Is it a yearly thing? It can't be a yearly thing, because there's 91 of them. It's only been around for, like, since...
I think they do one every...
Twice a year.
Yeah, I was going to say, it's like... I know they do more than one a year, but I couldn't... I almost wanted to say every quarter, but I felt like that was wrong, so...
So we have approximately 8.5 years to set it up.
Cool.
All right, you heard it here first. We're going to be at Comic-Con 108.
Comic-Con 108, here we come. What year is that?
And before, that would be, well, it's 8 years from now, so that would be, like 2024.
All right.
2024, I'm sorry. No, when we get to the 20s, everyone's, instead of saying, we're officially going to move from 2000 and to 20.
Nice.
You know, there's some people that say 2016, but more people, I think, say 2016. But once we get to the 20s, it's officially going to be 2020, 2021. Yeah. You know.
It'll officially be the future of the past.
So, yeah. We're going to be there.
The beckoning of the time
and
once
this video
of.
Will be really, really sad if one of us dies or Japan gets nuked in that time.
Why would we nuke Japan again?
Well, that's not. But the current Shinzo Abe has plans for the Japan that involve... rearming the military, banning, pretty weird stuff.
Really? Like what?
Like, for one, this is all stuff that he has to, like, he has to pass a bunch of stuff and then do a countrywide referendum.
Yeah.
To be able to do. But one of the things they want to do is suspend the Bill of Human Rights in Japan because they're too Western and don't fit Japan.
That sounds dangerous.
Yeah. So if Japan is otherwise a hellhole and doesn't have Comic-Con by then, I'm sure we'll be sad. But
now I see why. Yeah, maybe they'll... What if they ban anime because they think it's degenerate and gross?
That's what some people are thinking will happen if that does happen, is... I'm sure they'll still have anime, but it'll all be more like 70s and 80s stuff that's all like thinly veiled Japanese propaganda.
Hmm.
And there'll be less like doujins and hentai and frivolous anime that's nothing but fan service. So, of course, the people I heard about this from were like, oh yeah, that sounds great.
Isn't it 2020 when people expect Japan to be like depopulated and a terrible wasteland anyways because nobody fucks
over there? I'm pretty sure it'll take longer than that for literally everyone in Japan to die.
Well, no, I mean, like, aren't they already like understaffed?
They have a shortage of very young people, but they have plenty of middle-aged people. They just have a lot of old people.
Maybe they'll get the pound
town at some point.
There
will be
going.
A vacuum, but it won't be in the 2020s, I don't think.
And, you know, just get on with being boner lords or whatever.
5 viewers.
Whoa. Welcome to the
comfy stream, the rest of the Wicked part 1.
Stop saying that. That's not the name of the stream.
Yes, it is.
It's the fucking Zerp stream, because I'm sick, and that's that. All right. I'm going to put in some food.
Zerp it up,
here.
Bros.
Just rip it, stick it.
If you're going to zerp, I'm going to sniff this Sharpie all day.
What?
While we stream.
What?
I'm gonna,
how is it all day if it's only while we stream?
I'm going to partake in inhalant abuse.
I don't believe you. I just really don't.
I mean, I'll be honest. I think that things like gasoline and Sharpies smell good, but I know that you're not supposed to fucking sniff them because it'll fuck your brain up.
Well, I mean,
I don't know if I'm weird that I like the smell of gasoline. It seems really
all I really it. Have to say to that is, what are you really damaging?
Wow, that's fucking cool. until now, I thought we were friends. But you're really pushing it.
Maybe if you let me call my stream what I want to call it, we could be.
Alright. Yeah, you're right. We'll call it The Rest of the Wicked Part 1.
Son of a bitch, I'm going to stab you. I'm going to come to Minnesota just so I can stab you.
Good luck, I'm behind like 7 floors of yoga.
Of what? Geriatrics?
Yeah, they're all gonna fight you like Kung Fu Hustle style.
It's gonna be like fucking Tower Heist, but
yeah, old, a bunch people. Of old people, old fat people,
old World War II vets. Just
you don't
it
have
out.
To get to the top. You just have to get to the fourth floor, and there's an elevator.
Your hideout is not secure at all. Holy shit!
Then you'll have to discover which apartment I live in.
I'm pretty sure I have your address somewhere.
Oh, yeah.
You didn't think this one through, did you?
Yeah, you're right. I guess I'm going to have to name it The Rest of the Wicked Part 1.
Actual motherfucker. You literal incest lord.
Wow, that's really cool. I don't actually have to partake in sex with my own mother.
I'm glad you amended that, because I was going to make fun of you.
For what?
For, you know, I really don't know, actually. It's not really a reason to make fun of anybody, to be honest. I don't have anything against it. Look at this shitty train ride I made. Nobody's riding it? Like, four people are riding it. What does this even do? It goes down. And up and down.
If any of you guys want to visit me, just send yourself in a self-addressed stamped envelope to P.O. Box 900, Los Angeles, California, 90212.
You don't live in L.A.
Shut up.
I don't have to do anything you tell me, mister. You're not my dad.
Shut up, I don't do what you tell me.
Is that a reference to something?
I got the lyrics wrong, but let me,
Isn't it shut up when I'm talking to you?
It's fuck you, I don't do what you tell me.
Wow. That escalated violently. Why do you gotta be like that?
Killing in the name of some of those that work forces are the same that burn crosses. Again, he says it two times. Killing in the name of. Now you do what they told you four times. Those that died are justified for wearing a badge and their chosen white. You justify those that die for wearing their badge and their chosen white. Some, he does the killing in the name of and burning crosses again. And then he says, now you do what they told you four more times. And he says the part about the badge. And then he says, fuck you, I won't do what you tell me. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16 times in a row.
You've already got somebody on their way to L.A. Good job.
And then the end is, those that died are justified. You know, again, that the batch part.
Stop!
And that is,
holy shit!
That is killing in the name of, I'm gonna by Rage Against the Machine.
Drown you in liquid hate. Ugh. Well, good job. You already enticed one person to head on down to the glorious anarchist wasteland that is L.A.
Okay.
A place that would actually be better if it was like L.A. and Escape from L.A.
Nailed him.
I'm more or less saying it should just be a prison. It should just be a prison. It's awful there.
Let's turn all of California into a prison.
Yeah, let's do it. You know, I know this little hut is pointing at stuff, but I honestly thought that was a middle finger for a minute.
Huh.
Kind of wish it was now. Who the hell buys a giant hammer, anyways?
I don't know.
These should be free, so people will actually take them.
I think it's not a giant hammer. It's like a blow-up hammer.
Yeah, and then you've like
never seen those?
Yeah, run around the park just wailing on people with it, and then you get thrown out, and you know, they kind of scuff you up on the way out, but just blame it on the booze, and then they say they don't sell any booze in the park, and you're like, well then where did this flask come from? And then you get arrested for sneaking booze into a theme park, and buddy, that's just not a fun night.
Yeah. What you should be doing instead of that is staying home and drinking, and then going to Cam's meetup on 4chan and looking at the cock rate threads.
Yeah. Stay home and get drunk and look at cock all night. That's, like the rest of the world, I guess.
Oh, welcome back, Druin. You came at the best time.
Druin's back. Sir Derpington's back.
Oh, God, he got burritos. I'm fucking jealous now. What? Ah, fucker.
EDF. EDF.
Earth Defense Force.
I gotta make that work better so I can just do that.
Yeah.
Just saying.
You really should.
I don't know how to do that, though. I'm not...
Neither do I.
Not technical.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at my chub. I don't like those threads. They're bad.
Yeah.
Very bad. So many tiny pieces. Hey, speaking of penises, the Turgid Tornado has been fixed.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with tiny penises, but they never keep them up. They never upkeep them. They're always, like, tiny, but then also have really gross pubes and shit.
You know, I always just hate, like, in threads like that, or just sort of in threads in general, where they're like, hey, post your desk or whatever. You, alarm clocks, what?
It's not an alarm. I think Guy is referencing the thing in between the finger stand and the burger stand.
The lemonade stand?
Oh, yeah, that's a lemon, but it looks like the bell things that you'd see on the...
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, and you also really realize how many people have really weird shaped penises, too.
Anyways, to get away from that, what I was going to say is I don't...
Speaking of Dino Burger...
Oh my god, stop.
Let's edit the burgers. What do you got in there?
In a minute, hang on. Do I get to talk, or are you just going to screech at me about this? Holy shit. I don't even remember.
Well, I wanted to edit some burgers, but okay.
Okay, we'll edit some burgers, but I gotta give this enclosure more fence, because there's not enough... There's too many tigers to fit in the tiger house, because somebody keeps having tiger babies, and she just really needs to calm that shit down, to be honest with you.
Yeah, I like those. I wish I had a phone so I could participate in threads where it's, take a picture of X.
But I always just feel bad because there's always somebody that takes a picture of like their house or something, and it's just really sad.
Yeah.
Like, I don't know really how else to describe that. Need another animal house for the tigers. There we go. They can just live under the terrible slide. It's fine.
They can play underneath the supports of the giant bridge.
It's a slide, sir?
It's a slide. The giant slide. Live under the supports of the giant slide.
Anyways, you wanted to edit the burgers? The dino burgers?
Yeah. What kinds okay. you got in there?
Let's go look. Hi, dino burgers.
I want the triple fried grilled cheese.
They're burgers.
I want one of them. I want one of them without meat, goddammit. Just cheese and buns.
They're burgers. You have to have meat. It's not a burger without meat.
I don't care. Sell it. You can have other burgers, but I want one of them to be a grilled cheese.
Fine. You're crazy.
We got grilled cheese. Grilled we cheese. Want 1 pound burger. We want 2 pound burger. We want 3 4/4 burger.
You can't have a 3 4/4 burger. What?
You're right. 4 pound and 2 1/2 burger.
2 1/2 burgers? That's just one 1 pound burger, but twice.
No, I said I want a 4 4 1/2 pound burger.
Jesus Christ. Okay, a 4 and I can't put and.
No, you just do 1/2.
One, that's half pound.
No, but you start with 4 and then
we want a 1.5 pound burger. Is that what you're getting at?
4 1/2 lb burger.
4 1/2 pound burger.
Yeah.
That's fucking massive.
Well, let's call Donna Burger for a goddamn reason.
And then just a half pound and a 3/4?
No, then I want stuffed peppers.
Do you... Druin... Oh, dear. Wait, stuffed peppers? What?
Stuffed peppers.
Stuffed peppers. This doesn't make any sense. You don't make any sense.
And then I want a double 4 1/2 pound burger.
A 4 and a... What?
I want 4 1/2 pound burgers.
That's the same as a 4 1/2 pound. What are you even saying?
Okay, I'm sorry. The last one.
You don't even speak English. Glass. This isn't a drink. This isn't a drink stand. It's all burgers.
No, I want a glass of milk.
The lemonade stand can sell a glass.
Burgers and milk come from the same goddamn animal. Do what I want.
That doesn't make it not a burger. It's just gonna be a fucking burger called glass of milk. What's wrong with your theme park? What are you trying to run? This is a madhouse. Fine. It's a glass of milk. I named it. Go, that's for you. There you go. Don't.
And they're all free.
Yeah, we already covered that part. Obviously. Obviously. Wow.
Oh, Jesus.
I need some garbage cans in this wasteland. Fucking glass of milk.
We're lung problems.
No, we can't kill the people. We only have 3 people that are willing to listen to us. We can't kill them. That's bad.
Oh, Jesus.
So over by the Dino Burger.
I saw a thing that said custom image.
Yeah, you can upload stuff with custom images if you want.
Oh, I got one for you.
Yeah, but then I'd have to dig through it. I can save it for next time. It takes a little bit of effort to do that.
Alright.
We can put it in as a surprise to our loyal viewers.
Well, you should put in another sign, custom text sign that says suck with two C's and no K.
Why do you like those so much?
I don't know. I just think it fits the aesthetic. Finally, the outskirts of the park are getting the same treatment as the entrance area.
Hang on, I know what to do. We need to make sure people, when they get off...
You should use Atlantis bins more often.
Yeah, they're pretty cool. I really should.
LL wins because he has the best laugh. Sounds like bro team.
You sound like bro team.
Ugh.
Calm down. There you go. There's your sign.
My head hurts now because of all that laughing.
You fool.
Suck.
No one can reach Animal House 2. Don't tell me these...
And no one's going to see that great moment because it's behind like 40 minutes of a fucking train going through the goddamn desert.
Like 20 minutes. Calm down.
I might have to cut that out and make it be a highlight.
You could very easily do highlight streams, yes. Why are my... So apparently these supports actually block stuff from happening?
Wow. Barracuda Sunrise has very long queue times.
Even though the tigers can walk through them.
Wow.
I have ghost tigers.
Ghost tiger.
How does an ice cream stand break down?
They run out of milk?
Marvin shoved his wiener in the fucking...
All the milk being used to produce ice cream has been diverted to the burger stand.
God damn it. Fucking burger stand ruining milk. Let's build a ride.
Yeah, we've done Roller Coaster Tycoon in like pretty much every stream of the John's Comfy streams, so... This is a park we've been working on stream since the beginning.
Yeah. We just add stuff. The train thing, I feel like, is a fun way to open the stream, but someone disagrees.
Well, it was good because the one time we ended on it, and then we loaded where we left off for the start of the next one, but I think it's a bit redundant to start with it now. Not that I'm against streaming it, but I don't think it should be at the beginning. That's all I'm saying. That's all I'm saying. Nothing but love to the trains.
I don't believe you.
I mean, I love the trains. They're really great because I don't have to pay attention to what's happening on the stream.
Wow, that's the only reason you like them? Rip.
You know, maybe if you had somewhere interesting like Japan instead of California.
Terrible.
It's a joke because we found out that the Japan DLC is $40.
Yeah, I really wanted the trains in Japan, but it's 40 million buckaroons. Which is really just disappointing. Like... Why could you charge that much for Japan? It just seems criminal. Like, really criminal. Huh. What do you think, though?
If you buried your dragon dildos in a Chinese punji pit, in a pelican case, would that be enough to keep them from rusting? Would you need to include desiccant packets? How deep does it need to be? Is the waterproofing on the pelican cases not suitable for moisture while buried?
What?
If you buried your dragon dildos and Chinese punji pit spikes in a pelican case, would that be enough to keep them from rusting? Would you need to include desiccant packets? How deep does it need to be? Is the waterproofing on the pelican cases not suitable for moisture while buried?
Why? I mean, it's silicone, first of all. It doesn't rust. Also,
it depends on whether or not you had speared feces on the punji stakes beforehand. Many plebs make this error and end up with moldy dildos.
I don't have a response for that.
It's on K. It's a thinly veiled, hey, can I hide my guns in a thing underneath the ground?
Oh,
but
I see.
But instead of saying guns, they're saying dragon dildos and punji sticks.
So they're making a joke so that when the ATF swoops in and is like, yes, hey, we're going to ruin your jokering, and then the ATF says, oh, you're not actually talking about that.
But we all know the good way to get away from the ATF is to hide your guns, and when they come asking for them, you tell them that you lost them in a fishing accident. In a boating accident.
Fishing accident?
And they fell into the lake, and they're unretrievable.
But what? Why are you even taking your guns on a boat? You shark hunting or something? Why?
No, you're on a lake, boating, and then it tips over and you lost your guns.
Your scenarios are strange and don't make sense to me.
Maybe you're duck hunting. They do that on boats sometimes. Fuck off.
Are you gonna punt?
Yes.
Just out for a punt and a pint?
You're going camping and you're using a canoe for part of it, and you want your gun in case there's bears.
Okay, but what kind of bears? What kind of gun?
Black bears, brown bears, rifle.
Okay, what caliber?
Tech 9.
A tech what?
And a completely legal semi-automatic Tech 9.
Well, that's not going to stop a bear, first of all.
Sure will. You got 30 rounds. In this theoretical scenario, it's a black bear.
I still don't think that's going to do the business for you.
No, I mean, even the noise would scare it away, right?
I don't think so. I really don't think so.
I mean, black bears are fucking scaredy cats. You can spook them off with, like, fucking shake your keys at them and they run away.
I don't.
Unless I've got a cub.
Have you never been outside? Ever?
I live in Minnesota. I see black bears all the time. The scary ones are brown bears and grizzly bears.
I don't believe
it. Black bears are just, like, oversized raccoons. You can get fucked up by them, but only if you're messing with their kids. Otherwise, I'm not joking here. When I was down in my dad's house one time, there was a black bear in the yard, and their outdoor cat scared it away.
Really?
Yes.
Wait, I want to hear more about this bear-fighting cat that you apparently raised in Minnesota.
No. It was just a normal cat, and it, like, chased it, and the bear ran away. It was black and white, and it was normal size for a cat.
Is it standard for houses to come equipped with bear-fighting cats in Minnesota?
No.
Is that normal?
I mean, I think any reasonable cat would do this.
I don't believe you. My cat's a dumbass. It would probably piss itself and run away.
Yeah, that's enough to scare a bear.
I don't think that's...
Well, to be fair, your cat is an indoor cat.
Yeah, my cat is an indoor cat.
That cat was a cat that was let outside anytime it wanted.
I see. You think that would make the difference?
Yes. Because then they hone their hunting skills and realize that a bear has no threat to them. I can sense your power level. You're nothing to me.
I feel like a cat would still be scared of a bear.
Well, it would, like, hiss at it and, like, bat at it. And then the bear runs away. You can also scare them by honking your horn at them.
What?
Yeah. They're black bears. They're North American black bears. Anyway, I gotta use the thing that Indians call maize again, so I'll be right back.
Why do you keep saying that?
Here we go.
Where are you even going? No, stop. Come back. I demand it. It's fine. Everything's fine. You blinded a bull? What did it climb on its head or
Raccoons.
Something? Pee on its face? Like, what?
Yeah, I mean, cats can be fucking... They're fighters. That's the thing. Some of them are scaredy cats, but some of them are fucking grizzled badasses. The type of badass that watches Flubber with Robin Williams. The role of his lifetime.
Would you stop bringing up Flubber?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
You don't have to be such a flubberist. You really don't. I mean, I don't know
on
why.
On the day of his marriage, inventor Pete Brainerd makes a lot of mistakes. And one big flub.
Oh boy, you're just laying it on thick tonight.
Yeah. It's alright. Slicing it thick.
I can't handle your deli style hackerism.
Slicing it slick.
In fact, someone else couldn't handle it either. We're down to four. Look at that. Look what you did. Look what you did.
Ooh. That's a ripper.
Look what you did. That's okay. We got the milk joke out, and that's all that matters.
It's a real hangdog. Really took the wind out of my sails.
What?
It really took the wind out of my sails.
I'll take the wind out of your sails. I'll just suck the wind right out of those sails. You watch out.
Wow. That's way too explicit.
Suck.
It's way too explicit.
You're explicit.
Wow, that sucks, Turin. You were right to desecrate that maiden's grave.
Nice!
In fact, you should do it every single week. Just go and take a shit on his grave.
Yeah, just pee on graves. Who even cares? Not
only
the dead people.
Only the man who poisoned your cat. Just slowly dig away the dirt and replace it with shit until he's buried in shit.
Nothing could go wrong with that plan. Nothing at all. The only thing that could go wrong with that plan is when his horrible shit-covered ghost haunts your house. And then you like a new Stephen King novel, basically.
So what's your favorite meme recently?
My what?
Favorite meme recently.
What's a meme, sir?
You know.
I'm afraid I don't. sir.
Anyway, my favorite meme recently is when you'll be on a thread or somewhere and someone posts like a really dumb argument against someone or something, and then in response in all lower cap you say, "What the fuck, I hate the thing you mentioned now."
That seems dumb.
For example, someone will say, "Huh, look, Trump is blown the fuck out." And someone else says, "What the fuck, I hate Trump now."
Trixie is giving birth to another baby. Wow.
But it can apply to anything. It doesn't even have to be if someone says an argument. It can just be anything. Anytime a thing is mentioned, just say, "What the fuck, I hate so-and-so now."
I think that's silly. Why would you hate anything?
What the fuck, I hate roller coasters now.
Wow, get out of the stream.
You don't actually, the joke is that you don't actually hate.
The joke is that you're rude.
The joke is that you're still speaking. Child.
Wow. Yeah, that fucking tiger keeps having babies.
The joke is that you're still alive to draw breath.
Look at all these little babies. There's like six of them. Set 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Is this one dead? Troy the Tiger Jr. You? Oh no, it's not dead. Okay, cool.
Da-da-da-da-da. Boing.
Yeah, I got a lot of tigers up in here. They're banyan trees and they're perfectly natural looking waterfall. Perfectly natural looking in every way.
Banyan trees. They're not banyan trees, are they? I said that they were in the first stream, and you're like, "No, they're not banyan trees. They're western oaks or some shit."
No, I think those are banyan trees.
Well, why don't you look it up?
I'm looking it up right now. Yeah, they're banyan trees. I told you.
Well,
they're banyan trees.
I don't even care.
You do too. What? I'm getting memed at to say stuff that I don't understand. It's making me grumpy. In the butt. Fucking whore tiger. Damn right! A gay California? I don't understand. California. Hey, look, it's another one of these fuckers!
It's telling you to say that California is gay.
California is gay. Also, we got another hill walker. Just cruising. I don't know what I did when I installed the transit system over here, but occasionally people just walk across the void and like through hills to get to the other station, and then they just pop out over here and get on the ride. I don't know what they're doing. I don't get it.
Nice.
This ride is magic, apparently? I don't really know. Look at all these people that want to leave this shitty part of the park. Oh, it broke down. Straight into the trash, broke down.
Are you an expert on Warhammer Fantasy Battle?
No.
You know anything more than me about it?
Maybe.
What's the difference between an orc and a black orc?
Nope.
Oh, okay.
I think a black orc is like more points and they're more badass or something.
That seems weird.
Maybe they're chaos touched? I don't know.
They should just call them knobs.
But they're not.
Yeah, they
see,
are.
See, there he is, just walking. Like
the normal orcs are boys.
Walks all the way over boys. Here. Just get in line and get on the ride. See, burp. There he is. He runs on the ride. I don't understand. I don't understand. It's fine. Oh, people are riding this ride. Cool. Just looking at this roller coaster makes me feel sick. That's the kind of commentary I like to hear about my rides.
Yeah. Is it true they made bestiality legal in Canada?
Illegal or legal?
Legal.
I don't think so. I'm pretty sure we would have heard about that from our Canadian friend. Also, who cares?
Listen, I'm just trying to come up with topics to talk about.
So you want to talk about how you want to have a go at a dog? Is that what you're saying?
No. That would imply I would ever want to visit Canada.
Maybe they're trying to just get tourism up. They're desperate. I mean, I don't know. Personally, I think part of the fun of the show is just, you know, sneaking. Gotta sneak. Just find it. And you gotta sneak around. This fucking tiger house. It's gonna be the death of me. It just really does not want to be where it is. Can I just garbage it? Yeah, just garbage it. And put a new one in.
Hey, we're at five people. Were we ever at six?
No.
Or did we get the person back? Cool arena.
I may have enticed a new fool to come watch our goofy stream. A fiend of sorts. An excellent cool dude, even. Just saying. Okay. So as you can see, we've added some roller coasters to this theme park.
Yep.
You know, and it's pretty good.
Yeah.
But the question is, what do we do now?
Bomb it?
I don't think you can bomb the park.
Oh. I don't know. What was your suggestion? Kill a bunch of people?
I mean, if you want to bomb some stuff, we could just go for besiege for a little bit.
Sure, if you want. I can watch you be fucking terrible at games.
Holy shit. Bring in the pain. Why do
I
even...
like, what, two levels last time? Because nothing you did worked?
Wow.
And there were just piles of sharp objects and cannons that fell onto themselves and swirled around until they somehow managed to destroy everyone?
Just straight. Wow.
True.
Why do I even put up with you? I crawled all the way from the living room for this. I was watching nice TV. Nice TV.
Wow, yeah, TV.
Hey, you know what? TV is fucking pretty good, so don't give me any shit for TV, okay?
Yeah, TV, the most amazing...
Hey.
Panacea of the masses. Bread and fucking circus, am I right?
Hey, look, man, when I want to sit there and just get really fucked up, it's TV for me.
Then you just watch YouTube videos for 4 hours.
Fuck off. I can't be comfortable in my chair, okay? Like,
you have a TV that hooks up to your internet, unlike me.
Don't know what you mean by that.
Just some thoughts. A doctor's trip. Contemplations on reality.
Are you singing songs at me right now?
Let me show you. I'm going to bring you down to the town, and we're going to show you how to bring it around.
Hi, ruler. Also, nah, it could probably use more trains. It has a few train rides. That's over now, though. We're going to go blow stuff up now. Just saying.
It did have trains.
Yeah,
that's
like
besiege.
Three or four trains, actually.
So make a thing that has wheels that you can actually maneuver for once.
Okay, well, that's actually what I have to do for this level, so... Oh, wait, no, I somehow beat that level. I guess we're just blowing this thing up. Cool. I'm good at that.
Run it over.
Why would I run it over?
Smash it with wheels.
Why?
Do what I say.
Do what I want, not what I say. Is that what you're trying to get me with here?
Do what I want, not what I say. Yes, that's what I mean. It's do what I say, not what I do.
What?
It's no rest with the wicked.
No rest for the wicked. It's a time.
That's why we called it The Rest of the Wicked, Part 1.
Oh, okay, now I get it.
It's a joke that I'm saying no rest for the wicked wrong.
Oh, the joke is supposed to be that you're bad at things. I got it. Okay.
Isn't that always the joke for everything we make?
Pretty much! 100% of the time. To appease the Canadian. Build siege tanks. Fuck, can't. Wow! Chat's lit as fuck right now. Got a lot of opinions flying around.
Oh, Canada.
Oh, Canada.
Native land.
If Canada dies, how will we get bags of milk?
That's all I know. Canada theme song lyrics.
Canada theme song? That's a national anthem, not a
theme song.
Not a theme song! It's not a fucking...
Oh, Canada, I'm on the native land. To patriot love.
It worked!
My son's command.
Nice.
Wow, we got another viewer.
Nice, it worked. Yeah, ruler's hanging out.
No, we have 6 now.
Oh.
The true north, strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
Rocket Stick is a huge success. Twice in a row, even.
O Canada, that's a pretty good theme song.
What's a slow motion man?
Excuse me? I'm the one who can't sing slow motion man. He's on.
This is working a little too well for all these levels. I'm just gonna...
You created a one-use rocket battery? You just got a fucking Nebelwerfer?
Yeah, that seems to be succeeding at all the levels thus far. Like, three in a row. This
succeeded
is...
in that one so well that it just... completely hitched. Like, 1 second it was missiles, and then the next second you had won.
Alright, well, I finally found one where I'm not winning, so it's time to make a thing that can fly, I think. So here's what I'm going to do. I'm going to make a thing that lifts a bunch of rockets into the air, and then I'll unleash those rockets upon... my target.
Wow, you're gonna do an airlift!
Oh yeah, we're gonna airlift some rockets.
Make it in the shape of a cross so it can be like Evangelion.
Okay, hang on.
You know, I was just praising, what was I gonna say? Completely lost my train of thought. I was just praising Canada's theme song, but it's got nothing on A Cruel Angel's Thesis.
Isn't that... I gotta make sure this will actually lift. Okay, it lifts.
That's the theme song for Evangelion.
Please don't. Please don't. I beg you. Thank you.
Bye. So you just sent a crucifix into space using balloons.
I did. That's what just happened. Alright. So now...
War's changed.
War has not changed. War never changes. You should know this.
Finally, a weapon to surpass Metal Gear.
Finally. A weapon.
Finally home. I'm finally home.
Shit, this doesn't work. It just drops all the rockets.
Nice.
Why do the rockets fall off? Why?
Because it's such a sick party, all the doors are falling off.
It's not. Son of a bitch.
It just drops all the rockets.
It does, it just drops all the goddamn rockets. Alright, we're gonna fix this. I can fix this, it's fine. Alright, okay, so we're not gonna use rockets then. Obviously, that's the problem.
I can take you higher.
Lift higher. I wanna go higher. Deeper, stronger, faster, etc. I'm gonna put this on the front just because I can.
Yeah, I wish all nations of the world would just exchange their national anthems for anime theme songs.
Wow, what a weeb.
I'm gonna call it that America's would be the theme song for first stage of Initial D.
I don't know that song.
I'll have to show it to you sometimes.
Really too heavy. Shit.
Yamato will never fly.
Yamato will never fly. We're gonna make it happen. Oh, that's not what I want. Shit, that's ballast.
You heard it here first, guys. We're gonna, on top of visiting Kamiket in 2024, we're also going to find the remains of the Yamato in the Pacific and raise it to the top of the sea, bring it up, and also suspend it on balloons so it flies.
I think a lot of people would vote to change Canada's national anthem to that song. Because why not?
Nah, you're underestimating. People don't like Evangelion.
People love Evangelion.
I know, but I was making a joke.
Oh, almost. Come on, get in the air. Fug. It almost worked. I just need more stuff on there.
Just add more balloons.
I'm gonna add more balloons. You just watch.
I don't see how this is almost working.
It's gonna work. Just trust me.
You know, this thing also has no steering or...
It doesn't need any of that
stuff.
Anything
of any sort?
It doesn't need it. It just needs to go up so the guns get in line with the monument, and then we'll just destroy the monument.
It's completely wasteful. The whole point of this game is to make one machine that can do every single one of these challenges.
That is not the point of this game.
Well, it is once you beat it. Then you're like, oh, well, let's make one multi-machine that can beat every single challenge. People do that, you know.
You know what?
This is never going to flow.
I give up. Fine. Is that what you wanted? Is that what you wanted?
I mean, it was pretty obvious that that is never going to happen. Adding more balloons is just adding more weight.
Look, I wanted to believe in something. You're taking that away from
Make
me.
Make something that is on wheels, and then it can pivot backwards lower so it's aiming up at an angle. Or, since you don't know how to do any of that, just make something that will naturally rest up at an angle.
Hey, I know how to do stuff. I'm gonna do it. You'll see.
Okay, so now, since you've made the square, make it so that there's like two things holding it up on the front so that it's angled upwards.
I'm doing it. Calm down.
Oh, okay.
Just let me have this. You always tell me what to do.
I Make a train boucher?
Train boucher? Do you mean a trebuchet?
Yeah, but one that fires trains out of it.
I don't think I can make that in this game.
Yeah, you could, technically. You couldn't, but someone could.
Wow! Just straight... God damn it. Fuck. Shit.
Fire all engines. Obviously, it would be more efficient to... You have three of them there, but if you put them on the back rank, it would you can have another five. Oh, they'll fall off anyway.
I don't understand.
Very impressive.
They violently veered away at the last second. God damn it. They keep just going to the left.
There's a wind there.
Oh, there's a wind there. Oh. Now the game tells me.
It won't hit the target.
But there's a wind there. Oh. Fucking oh. None of you thought to explain this before me. To me.
I didn't realize.
Fuck.
I saw what happened.
Fuck. It's back to cannons then, I guess. Oh, there's a wind there. Yeah, cannons save the day. Fuck you, wind. I do it. I did it. Put a man on the moon.
I love that half of it falls apart and starts fucking jimmying all over the place.
What's wrong with that?
I love that nothing you make can stay alive after it completes its mission.
Hey, we just gotta get the job done, not make something, you know, pretty.
Fire!
Alright, this mission is gonna be harder. So, it's gonna take more stuff.
Just make five of those and stack them.
Yeah, basically. Oh, they already fucked up. Actually, let's just do some test shots
here. Is there anything that's like more powerful than the wood that constantly falls apart because you put 4,000 cannons on it?
You can like girder the wood and make it stronger and stuff, I guess.
You should do that more often.
Why? It's funnier the other way.
Sure.
Success. And... didn't totally die today. Welcome to Besiege. Nothing good ever gets built here. That's exactly the thing that's happening.
Well, it does, but not by him.
Wow! Why you gotta be so mean?
I'm just being honest.
You know, you don't have to be.
Well, I know you're strong enough to take it.
Wow. What if I'm not?
Because you're high on the Zerp!
Zerp fiends never die. I'm due for more in about a few minutes, though, so that's when shit's really gonna get lit.
Rikamaru.
Rikamaru.
Whew, Rick and Morty.
People say that's a good show, and I don't believe them.
Yeah, I hear it's pretty good. Vinny likes it. We like Vinny, right? You know him.
Of course Vinny
likes it. He's
spoken
to us.
Actually, yeah, he's a chill dude, actually.
That's right. You heard it here first, guys. We know Vinny from Vine Sauce.
We've communicated with him, yes. He's actually a pretty nice guy, I have to admit.
We're best friends with Vinny from Vine Sauce.
I don't think I would go so far as to say that, but okay.
We personally write all the scripts for Michael from Vsauce.
We do not do that at all. Okay, well that's not going to work.
Oh, you just have the grabbers hold onto the rockets for next time.
I don't know if grabbers work that way, but it's a possibility, I guess.
Why would you make...
What?
Why would you make a rear-wheel drive front steering car?
Well, it's front-wheel drive. Why do you sound so upset about that?
I'm gonna go watch a video that one of my friends made of them beating a level in a game.
Wow. That's
more impressive.
You're not even gonna stick through this with me, huh? Wow. I see what kind of dedication I get from you.
This has Eurobeat playing in the background. Do you have Eurobeat playing in the background?
No.
Exactly.
Why would I have Eurobeat playing in the background of this?
Because it's the best genre of music known to man?
I don't believe you.
Are you a speedy, speedy boy? No.
Look, I don't know what your fascination with Eurotraps is, but, you know. I grabbed this tree that's almost like the wood they want, right? Let go of the tree now. Oh, Jesus. V. Okay.
Wow, you grabbed the tree.
I just said that. I did indeed grab the tree.
Just imagine how much this video would be improved if this thing was driving around with Eurobeat playing.
Look, if you want me to get some... Europa beat. I mean,
yes, man. Get some royalty free Euro beat and play it right now.
I don't know any. You do it. You're the one that knows all the crazy Erasmo beats. If you like Eurobeat so much, why don't you marry it? Grab her.
Come on, you never surrender. Takumi.
Hey, do you want a taco? Is that what's happening? Hup.
Running Hup. In the 90s. This is why you need a rear-wheel drive front-wheel steering car?
I don't understand what you're getting at.
So you can, like, make...
This is totally working, don't worry. Shit.
Okay, all you need to do is have the front wheels be attached to those things that, like, use in the level where you raised it up to fire the cannons up. Have those on the front, and then have the wheels be attached to those so you can pivot it up.
But this is totally working.
Oh, yeah, of course, but on the slight possibility that it doesn't work.
Why wouldn't it work? As you can clearly see, it's totally working. See, the real problem is I can't lift the things up. That's the real problem. Alright, so... See, I've got to figure out how to get one of them up there. You know, the farmers are running away. Don't run away. I have a present for you. Yep. Nope. Okay, well, this is very, very... It's good.
You want to try my idea now?
I mean, I might. Okay.
Zankoku naten shinote.
Stop it.
Sorry.
Yeah, I know your secret.
Mato henkara. I can't. I'm out of tune now. Fuck me up.
Fuck boys never die. Just think about that.
Well, I could sing this entire thing.
Yeah?
Could you? Yeah. I could. Want to challenge me?
No.
Put money on this?
I don't want to challenge you. I mean, we've only got, like, 5 more minutes anyways.
Yeah. I could do it, and I could do it 5 times.
I don't believe you.
Are you going to put down money on it? Are you going to fucking challenge me?
No, I'm not going to put down money on it.
That's what I thought, because you know that I could do it.
Would you calm down about this?
No. I refuse.
But why?
Takumi! Takumi!
Why?
Wow, you made a very, very amazing machine.
Why are you talking about this taco meme for? I don't understand.
Taco meme! Taco meme!
Stop taco memeing at me.
Saying Takumi.
Taco meme! Yeah, I know. I heard you. Menace the farmers.
It's not even balanced right, you fuck.
That's why it menaces the farmers so good. Don't worry about it. It's perfect and beautiful. And I love it.
Jesus Christ.
You know what it needs to do, though? It's missing something really important. Thanks for watching Besiege, where nothing gets done and I don't know what I'm doing.
I gave you the answer to this thing, but then you just destroyed the machine that was half working.
Look. I have a solution.
You utter sponge. You donkey.
Wow, why would you call me a drunkie?
Donkey.
Why would you call me a donkey? That's rude.
Because that's what Gordon Ramsay says.
Why would you want to be like Gordon Ramelov?
Because he's like a famous cook and has tons of money and a wife.
So you just want tons of money and a wife? It's flying!
No, I don't want a wife. I would sell the wife for more money.
Wow, that's fucked up.
You did it. You made a flying machine in a level that requires no such thing.
Okay. Okay.
You made a land jellyfish.
I made a landmasser.
That slowly destroys its own locomotion. Flight.
I feel like that's a metaphor for life. So just don't worry about it, okay?
Druin says, this is the stupidest thing.
I am wounded. I am vexed. I'm poxed. I can't believe. I can't
Poppin'
believe.
J.
I can't believe.
Poppin' J.
Can't even believe.
Nice box. Now get rid of the back legs for one.
Oh, I've got a plan.
Wait. Jesus Christ.
Well, you know, Thanks for watching. Here, let's do that again. See, I got this lovely thing. It's lovely.
I don't see how you thought that was going to work.
It's perfect.
It should have been facing up if that was going to work at all, you fucking idiot.
It's perfect! It's perfect! Oh, three times the charm.
Oh, fuck.
Beautiful.
Didn't even kill the farmers.
The farmers, for once, are safe. Anyways. Thanks for hanging out for a sick joke stream. The rest of the Wicked, part one.
You can't end the stream yet? There's still 2 minutes?
I'm not ending it right now.
Okay.
Calm down. I'd like to thank our sponsor.
We have a contractual obligation with Bad Dragon Incorporated to run this for exactly 2 hours.
If you want large silicone, they sell that. So thanks.
If you want large, expensively produced... No. I'm trying to say...
If you want some made-in-the-USA genuine destruction devices...
If you buy silicone from them, you're getting it at a very, very bad exchange rate because they mold the silicone to look like things.
Yeah, if you're just after silicone, there's really better ways.
I don't think anyone would make money buying dragon dildos and... melting them down and selling the raw silicon again.
No, there's no aftermarket, unfortunately.
I mean, there is aftermarket for them, but not when you melt them down first.
No.
And it's very strange and weird that there is an aftermarket for them, but there is.
There is?
Yes.
That makes me uncomfortable. Let's just gloss over that.
It's only lightly used ones.
Because it's... on the money! Thanks for hanging out.
This was part one of the rest of the Wicked stream. We'll be back for more topics about bad dragon dildos in part two.
Yep, and more Canada memes.
Oh. Sick. Still got 20 seconds, so let's fill the air. And I'll tell you when you can stop.
Why? Look, we can't just say goodbye for a million hours.
Well, we have like 8 seconds left. We can do it.
I don't think we can.
Yeah, we three,
in,
two,
in fact...
One. Okay, we can stop the stream right now.
We're, okay. Thanks, guys. Have a good one. See you at whatever time we do this again next week.
Remember, if you go to baddragon.com and you enter our code...
Our code...
Synonymous botch, you get 10% off.
You do. You really do. It works. I tried it. Okay, bye, guys. Have a nice night.